So a very good morning to all of you, my dear students. Welcome back to the class once again. Now we have to discuss about the importance of Gram Panchayat. We have completed this first paragraph. Let us go to the second paragraph also. The Gram Panchayat suffers. And suffers means unko pareshani bhi hota hai. Kisi se? About from the shortcomings. Shortcomings means many a time they require more fund, but they have less fund. Hai na? They don't have more fund to complete their work. So that is the thing that is most of the time they suffer from this shortcoming. Shortcoming yani kam ho jate. Paise utne nahi rehte jitna unko chahiye kaam ko finish karne ke liye. That is the thing, my dear students. They don't have enough financial resources. Financial resources means we are talking about the money, amount of money that they used to get from the state government or from the donation or from the taxes. They are not enough. Hai na? Wo sare utne kaafi nahi hote pure kaam ko karne ke liye. And every time, if your father is earning 1 lakh rupees hai na, per month, then at that time also it will be a shortcoming. Wo bhi kam pad jayega. Agar kisi ke papa 1 lakh kamate hain, kisi ke papa 2 lakh kamate hain mahine mein, phir bhi kam pad jata hai. Because there are many expenses nowadays na. The government does not give them sufficient grant. The government does not give them all the amount. The government does not have so much amount to give them full. So they also do not give them sufficient. मतलब जितना देना चाहिए grant, उनका grant उनको नहीं मिलता है. We are talking about whom? About the Gram Panchayat. They do not get sufficient amount of grant of money. They do not have sufficient amount of money to do all the work. The taxes levied means I yesterday also did that. Taxes levied by them are meager, very small. They are there is also interference in its work by the government official also. Government officials bhi aake disturb karte hain, wo bhi kehte hain ki we also have to do this work and that work. Because the more money we get, the more we spend. Yes, Ayush is right. The more money we get, the more we start spending also. So that's why it always become less. So you can see petty politics and casteism, and based on casteism and community means favoritism. I'm talking about favoritism or petty politics. छोटे छोटे politics होते रहते हैं गांव में. है ना, वो एक दूसरे को फेवरेट करते हैं. दे यूज्ड टू से नो द रोड शुड बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड इन फ्रंट ऑफ माय हाउस फर्स्ट. द अदर विल से नो द रोड विच इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ माय हाउस इट वेरी बैड, प्लीज स्टार्ट कंस्ट्रक्टिंग द रोड फ्रॉम हियर. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स गोज ऑन एंड समटाइम they used to say among themselves, in those places only Dalit families are living, only Ansari's families are living, so leave them, and leave them first, let us construct the road at our places, in our colony. Other will say let us construct the road in our colony. Other will say give us the light facility first in our colony. So like this type of things also goes on, and community, based on community or based on casteism as well. Someone will say, oh, only the Christian people are living at that particular place, why to spend money on those Christians people? So this type of politics also goes on, means discrimination goes on, which is really bad for our society, which is really bad for our country as well. So let us complete this one. These three levels of panchayat system that I yesterday also discussed with the help of a PowerPoint presentation. Let us discuss it once more so that you can get well aware of it. The panchayati raj system is the lowest level of the democratic government. That is the lowest level, means that is the third tier of government. Na? After central government and state government, this is the third tier, means that is the lowest level of government. That is why I am saying over lowest doesn't mean the bad one. Lowest means at the bottom. You know, this is the government system that is which is at the bottom. We follow three tier panchayati system. Now there are three tier even in the panchayati system, means as a whole there are three levels of government, but also there is a three tier of system in the panchayati raj system as well. There is three tier. Now who are they? Let us see. Above the Gram Panchayat, ग्राम पंचायत के ऊपर कौन है? द विलेज लेवल, एट विलेज लेवल इज द प्रखंड पंचायत, और यू कैन से पंचायत समिति. दैट आई टोल्ड यू दैट अ ग्रुप ऑफ ग्राम पंचायत, दे फॉर्म व्हाट, दे कम टुगेदर, दे आर नोन एज पंचायत समिति. मींस अ फ्यू ग्राम पंचायत कैन टुगेदर मेक पंचायत समिति. देन हु इज बिगर, ग्राम पंचायत और पंचायत समिति? Always write your answer in the chat box. Who is bigger, panchayat samiti or gram panchayat? Always panchayat samiti is the is above, is bigger, hai na? Panchayat samiti, yes, no, yeah, panchayat samiti is the right answer. Very good, my dear students. So at the block level, panchayat samiti is always larger, hai na? Because it is a group of gram panchayat. So panchayat samiti is bigger. But a group of panchayat samiti, you can say a panchayat samiti has many gram panchayat under it. That is the correct statement over here. That is the real statement, that a panchayat samiti has many gram panchayat under it. Hai na? A group of gram panchayat becomes panchayat samiti. Very good, everyone. Everyone is right, my dear students. You are all very intelligent. And above the panchayat samiti, a panchayat samiti ke bhi upar koi hota hai. And who is that above panchayat samiti? That is jila parishad. Because a group of panchayat samiti makes or become district panchayat, or you know, it is also known as jila parishad as well. Okay. So now, who is bigger? Tell me, panchayat samiti or jila parishad? Who is bigger among them? Write your answer. Jila Parishad or Panchayat Samiti, which is bigger? Very good. Jila Parishad is the right answer, my dear students. So, is tarike se kya ho gaya? Who is at the top? Jila Parishad at the top. Who is below Jila Parishad? Right in the chat box. Who is below Jila Parishad? Yes, Panchayat Samiti is below Jila Parishad. And now, who is below Panchayat Samiti? Who is below Panchayat Samiti? Yes, Noor Nawaz Khan is right. Yes, Gram Panchayat. Very good. Yes, Sanjam, Srishti, Rajveer, Rambia. Everyone is right, my dear students. Your really is Panchayat Prakhand is also that. Very good. My intelligent students of grade 6. Very good. So you can see there are three tiers of government na, in the Panchayat system as well. Jila Parishad and then Panchayat Samiti and then Gram Panchayat. Okay, so that is why that is also shown over here in this. You can see Jila Parishad is at the top, Block Samitis mean Panchayat Samiti is at the bottom, at after Jila Parishad, you can below Jila Parishad, and Village Panchayat means Gram Panchayat is below Panchayat Samiti. That is shown in this diagram, in this particular image. Very good, intelligent students. Jila Parishad, then Panchayat Samiti, and then who is at the bottom? Gram Panchayat is at the bottom. Or you can say other name of Gram Panchayat is Village Panchayat. Very good, my dear students. So we have understand that three level of government, three tier of government in the Panchayat government, Panchayati Raj also. Now let us see Prakhand Panchayat or Panchayat Samiti, their work. Na? The Panchayat Samiti is the middle tier. Yes, it is, they are in the middle. Na? Because above Panchayat Samiti is the Jila Parishad. And below Panchayat Samiti is the Gram Panchayat. So Panchayat Samiti is at the middle. As this is organized at block level, it is also called Block Samiti also. So this is organized, this Panchayat Samiti is organized as block level. So that is why it is also called as Block Samiti. Okay, that is, you can say that Panchayat Block Samiti is the other name of Prakhand Panchayat or Panchayat Samiti. Block Samiti is another name. The members are elected by the Sarpanch. Now, who is to elect the members of this particular Panchayat Samiti? I told you always that there are always a Sarpanch, you know, who is the head of 300 houses, 500 houses in a village, and who is the head of all. So, the members are elected by this Sarpanch, or known as, they are also known as Pradhan also. And they are the Sarpanch of village panchayat. Yes, Gram Panchayat mein do type ki log hote hai na. There are two type of people, Panch and Sarpanch. So now the Sarpanch, all the Sarpanch of all the villages used to elect the members of Panchayat Samiti. Besides, all the members of the parliament and the state legislature belonging to the block are the members of the panchayat samiti. So aur kaun log kaun kaun se members hain wahan par panchayat samiti mein? The lok sabha पार्लियामेंट के मेंबर्स यानी के एमएलएज एंड इवन स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर पंचायत बिलोंगिंग टू द मेंबर्स ऑफ द पंचायत समिति. तो दीज आर आल्सो द मेंबर्स यानी मेंबर्स ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट. मेंबर्स ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट को बोलते हैं शॉर्ट में एमएलए, है ना, एमपी बोलते हैं, सॉरी, मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट एमपी. एंड द स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर ऑल्सो, दे आर ऑल्सो द स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर एमएलए बिलोंगिंग टू द ब्लॉक्स आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ पंचायत समिति. सो Beside का मतलब ये लोग भी हैं. The sarpanch used to elect the members of the panchayat samiti as well. These people are also the members, MPs and MLAs. The block development officer BDO है ना acts as a secretary of the panchayat samiti. पंचायत समिति के secretary कौन है? The block development officer is the secretary of, yes, member of legislative assembly. They are known as MLA. And member of the parliament name, they are known as MP. Okay. So you can see over here the BDO, yani block development officer, is the secretary of the panchayat samiti, and its term of 5 years. Again, in 5 years, everything will be changed. The secretary can be changed, the members of the parliament can be changed, MLA can be changed, and everyone can be changed. Yes, BDO means block development officer. It they can also changed. Yes, few students are raising hand. I will let them speak after completing this last paragraph over here. The panchayat samiti cooperates and coordinates. You can see panchayat samiti kya karta hai, cooperate bhi karta hai aur coordinate yani ki direction bhi deta hai kisko, with the help of BDO. The panchayat samiti cooperates and coordinates with the BDO. BDO means block development officer in implementation of the development programs. So the government has many development programs for the people of the village. So BDO ko help kaun karte hain? The members of the panchayat samiti, as well as they help and they coordinate also. They give them direction. Block development officer gets the direction from the panchayat samiti. The samiti provides team of experts, you can see, to guide and advise the panchayat. Means they used to send their expert people to teach the people how to grow crops, how to grow crops, how to do cultivation, and how can they use the resources, how can they use their money in the village for the welfare of the village, for the welfare of the village people. All these are done by the panchayat samiti and block development officer. They used to direct the people. They used to send expert team of people. This relates to development of agriculture. That I told you, agriculture, yani ki kheti baadi kaise karna hai, hai na, beech kab dalna hai, aur usme pani kitne baar dalna hai. All these things, hai na, how, when to sow the seeds, when to give water to the field, hai na, when to harvest the crop. Everything is guided and directed and taught by the expert people to the villages. Even this relates to development, promotion of local industries. Yes, many a time they used to come to the village, people used to, expert people come, and they used to teach people that you can start this type of work, you can start this type of industries, and it can be done. Someone is asking, can a mukhya or sarpanch be a ward member or BDO? It is always not happen. It doesn't happen always that mukhya is also a ward member also, because if you will give the same person two type of responsibilities, then the things cannot be done at a very good level. So they are always not, but they can be. Okay. So even experts, they come to the village, they taught people, na, how to start new industries, how to start new work, and which type of work is very fruitful, it will be advantageous, na, they will get a lot of money, profit. Even they used to teach them improvement of livestock. Livestock means we are talking about the animals which are having life, na, they are also having life. So livestock means what? Livestock means that is the animals which are having life. Even the construction and maintenance of road, bridges, everything, people used to come, expert people used to come to the village, and they used to guide the villagers that how they can improve their livestock, you know, how can they increase their animals, how can they rear their animals, how the roads can be constructed and how the bridges can be done constructed. They used to teach the people about all these things. It is the apex body, you know, Jila Parishad. It is the apex body. Apex means at the top, you know. So they are the body at the top of this three tier system of the Panchayati Raj in India. And what is their work? Let us see. ये लोग क्या करते हैं? It examines. Before discussing about the work of Jila Parishad, we have discussed about the work of, you can see, Panchayat Samiti, you know, here we have discussed. Now we are going to discuss the work of Jila Parishad. It examines, the first work is what? It examines and coordinates the activities of the Panchayat Samiti in the district. Because they are head now, they are head, they are above Panchayat Samiti. So they will coordinate and they will examine the work of whom? Panchayat Samiti. They will examine as well as कोऑर्डिनेट, यानी वो लोग एग्जामिन भी करेंगे, चेक भी करेंगे और कोऑर्डिनेट यानी हेल्प भी करेंगे पंचायत समिति को कि वो अपना काम कर सके सही से. द जिला परिषद ऑल्सो सर्व एज ए लिंक बिटवीन द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड पंचायत समिति विद इन अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट. दैट इज गुड. जिला परिषद इज एक्टिंग एज ए लिंक बिटवीन स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, क्योंकि जिला परिषद से ऊपर कौन है? अब स्टेट गवर्नमेंट है. तो जिला परिषद और पंचायत समिति के बीच को जोड़ने का काम जो कौन करता है? ये स्टेट गवर्नमेंट है ना, एक्ट एज ए लिंक बिटवीन द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड पंचायत समिति. यानी पंचायत समिति के ऊपर कौन है? जिला परिषद. तो पंचायत समिति के लोग गवर्नमेंट तक कैसे पहुंचेंगे? द जिला परिषद विल एक्ट एज ए लिंक, है ना, दे विल प्रोवाइड एज ए लिंक टू रीच टू द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. सो द पंचायत समिति कैन रीच टू द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट विद द हेल्प ऑफ टेल मी, with the help of Jila Parishad. Panchayat Samiti can reach state government, can reach the chief minister with the help of Jila Parishad only. They cannot cross Jila Parishad, because the government will not entertain any one of the requests from Panchayat Samiti without the interference of Jila Parishad. That is the thing. Yes. तो बहुत जरूरी है कि जिला परिषद से होकर ही आप आगे बढ़े. पंचायत समिति डायरेक्ट नहीं जाएंगे वहां पर सीएम से मिलने के लिए, है ना, चीफ मिनिस्टर से, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट से. सो द कंपोजिशन ऑफ जिला परिषद वेरीज फ्रॉम स्टेट टू स्टेट, है ना. कंपोजिशन मींस द मेडअप ऑफ जिला परिषद, हाउ इट इज फॉर्म, इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम स्टेट टू स्टेट. इट कंसिस्ट ऑल द चेयरमैन ऑफ द पंचायत समिति इन अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट, ओके, है ना. लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड हु आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ जिला परिषद नाउ. All the chairman of Panchayat Samiti means all the men, all the head of the Panchayat Samiti, they are the members. Beside that, उसके अलावा और कौन होते हैं members? Members of Parliament होते हैं, है ना, that is MP, and even state legislature, वहाँ भी member होते हैं, वो लोग भी member होते हैं, belong to this district, are the members of Jila Parishad. यानी all high level persons are there, members of Parliament भी हैं, state legislature के लोग भी हैं, और यहाँ तक के DM भी हैं वहाँ पर, and even head of all the panchayat samitis are also there. All the members of Jila Parishad elect a president. Now, अब यही सारे members क्या करते हैं? आपस में से एक आदमी को elect करते हैं as a president. They used to elect one person as a president among them, and they used to elect one vice president also. Suppose if president is not well, है ना, in health, is not having good health, then who will handle all the work? Vice president. That's why they elect two person, president and vice president. Even the state government appoints a secretary who maintains records and accounts of Jila Parishad. State government is also very good, very clever. They used to appoint a secretary, ana, that is government person from the government, ana, who will get salary from the government. Then he or she will work for the government only. And what is the work of that secretary? Maintaining the records and accounts of Jila Parishad. Jila Parishad ka records ko kya kaam kar rahe hain Jila Parishad, aur unka accounts aur saath saath unke records sare wo maintain karenge, yani kahan kahan wo paise ko expend kar rahe. Where are they spending their money? All are recorded. Next, aur kya kaam karte hain Jila Parishad? It coordinates the plans of the panchayat samiti and advises the government on the working of the system. Yeah, it advises the government, also jila parishad government ko advise bhi karte hain, and even coordinate the planning of the panchayat samiti. Panchayat samiti ke saath plan banate hain ki kaise hum logon ko kisi cheez ko complete karna hai. It allocates funds received from the government to the panchayat. Allocate means distribute over here. So it distributes the fund between different panchayat samiti. With the fund which is received from the government. So government से जो fund आता है उसको कौन distribute करते हैं? ये जिला परिषद distribute करेंगे different different पंचायत समितियों को. Function of जिला परिषद are mostly supervisory and advisory in nature. है ना? They used to supervise and they used to advise. These are the two things जिला परिषद do. It has no executive function. Executive function मतलब implement करना, programs को implement करना, और उसके अपने पास में फंड भी नहीं होता है. दीज आर नॉट द वर्क ऑफ जिला परिषद. दे डू नॉट एग्जीक्यूट द प्लानिंग्स. दे मेक प्लानिंग्स, दे मेक प्लान, दे कोऑर्डिनेट इन मेकिंग द प्लान, बट दे आर नॉट एग्जीक्यूटिंग. यानी प्लान को इम्प्लीमेंट करने का काम जिला परिषद करेंगे. पंचायत समिति एंड ग्राम पंचायत, दे विल एग्जीक्यूट द प्लान, बट द प्लान विल बी मेड बाय जिला परिषद एंड पंचायत समिति. ऑल टूगेदर विल सिट एंड मेक ए प्लान, बट इट विल नॉट बी एग्जीक्यूटेड. Even gram jila parishad does not have their own fund. Jila parishad ka apne paas paisa bhi nahi hota hai. Only state government gives amount of money to the jila parishad, and then it is sent to the gram panchayat and even the members of the villages. Our constitution directs the government to organize panchayats. Hai na, constitution hamara kya kehta hai government ko ki panchayat banaiye. The idea is to promote people participation in the local admission. Aur idea kya hai ki logon ka participation hona chahiye local level mein bhi. So that is why our constitution is saying to organize panchayat also. So that is all in this class, my dear students. Hai na, that is Nyay Panchayat. We will go through in our next class. And if you have time, then please reconnect. Hai na, ye class khatam hone ke baad aap reconnect kar le dobara. Hai na, then we will complete this tomorrow, today only. So after okay, my dear students, we will study about this Nyay Panchayat. Discuss about this Nyay Panchayat also. Let us zoom it more. न्याय पंचायत. न्याय पंचायत का मतलब गिविंग जस्टिस. न्याय का मतलब होता है जस्टिस करना, है ना, इंसाफ करना. सो लेट अस सी द जुडिशियल विंग ऑफ द पंचायत इज कॉल्ड द न्याय पंचायत. जुडिशियल विंग ऑफ द पंचायत, पंचायत का एक अलग से विंग होता है, यानी कि वो उड़ने के लिए नहीं होता है. द विंग इज दैट इज ए डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ वर्क, and that department is known as Nyay Panchayat, means giving justice to the people, means they try to solve the issues of the village at the village level. First they used to try to solve that particular thing at the village level. Isliye village ke level par ek Nyay Panchayat bhi banaya gaya hai. There is generally one Nyay Panchayat for a few gram panchayat, hai na, bahut sare gram panchayat ka कभी कभी एक ही न्याय पंचायत होता है. मैंने सारे न्याय पंचायत जो होते हैं वो सारे ग्राम पंचायत के प्रॉब्लम्स को सॉल्व करेंगे. दे यूज्ड टू सॉल्व ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ ऑल दोस ग्राम पंचायत पीपल. मींस मे बी टू विलेज, थ्री विलेज टुगेदर मे हैव ओनली वन न्याय पंचायत. नो, डोंट गो फॉर ब्रेकफास्ट एंड बाथ, वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स. सो न्याय पंचायत एंड ग्राम पंचायत के लिए, ग्राम पंचायत, बहुत सारे ग्राम पंचायत के लिए एक न्याय पंचायत भी हो सकता है. विलेज पंचायत सेंड इलेक्टेड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स टू द, नाउ विलेज पंचायत, विलेज पंचायत मींस ग्राम सभा. दे यूज टू इलेक्ट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ द न्याय पंचायत, है ना. न्याय पंचायत में कौन लोग होंगे, दैट विल बी ऑल्सो इलेक्टेड बाय द ग्राम सभा, यानी मींस द एडल्ट मेंबर्स ऑफ द विलेज ओनली. दे विल इलेक्ट द पर्संस हु विल बी देयर इन द न्याय पंचायत. It settled, है ना. Now what is the work of न्याय पंचायत? They is to settle all small disputes over property or theft. अगर किसी के घर में चोरी हो गया है और अगर कोई प्रॉपर्टी के लिए कोई लड़ रहे हैं, दो भाई आपस में लड़ाई कर रहे हैं, then they is to settle this type of dispute among the people at the local level, है ना. न्याय पंचायत में ये सॉल्व किया जाता है. They can impose fine up to ₹500. They can't send a culprit to jail because they are solving at the local level. They will not send anyone to jail, है ना. They can fine, है ना. अगर किसी ने चोरी वगैरह किया है, छोटा मोटा बात है और अगर लड़ाई हो रहा है, they can fine, but they can't send to jail. They can try civil and revenue cases of a minor nature, है ना. Criminal case है या पैसे से रिलेटेड कोई केस है ना, नॉट द क्रिमिनल वन, दे डोंट डील विद द क्रिमिनल केसेस, ओनली द सिविल केसेस, यानी भाई भाई में लड़ाई हो गया है, दो फैमिली के बीच में लड़ाई हो गया है ना, इफ टू फैमिलीज आर फाइटिंग अमंग ईच अदर, सो दे कैन सॉल्व ऑल दिस थिंग. इवन रिवेन्यू केसेस, यानी पैसे से रिलेटेड कोई मैटर है, तो देन दे कैन सॉल्व एट दैट पर्टिकुलर लोकल लेवल, बट माइनर नेचर, यानी कि छोटा होना चाहिए, बहुत बड़ा नहीं होना चाहिए मैटर. इफ इट इज वेरी बिग मेजर problem is there, then they will have to go to the court or the police will come in between. The process of justice is quick, inexpensive and simple. और इंसाफ मिलने का तरीका जो है, प्रोसेस है, वो बहुत आसान है, बहुत फास्ट है. बिकॉज एट बैट पर्टिकुलर ऑन द स्पॉट जस्टिस विल बी डिलीवर्ड, है ना, इंसाफ कर दिया जाएगा ऑन द स्पॉट. ये नहीं कि डेट के बाद डेट लगाया जाएगा, नो नो डेट्स विल बी गिवन. इनएक्सपेंसिव, यानी लोगों का कुछ खर्च भी नहीं होता है. दे डोंट हैव टू हायर एनी लॉयर ऑल्सो बिकॉज इट इज सॉल्व एट द लोकल लेवल एंड इट इज सिंपल. No lawyers are allowed to appear before a new न्याय पंचायत. न्याय पंचायत में कोई लॉयर का काम ही नहीं है. So no lawyer can represent there, can be present there. Villagers are spared undue hassles and delay. As they say, justice delays is justice denied. Yes. Villagers are spared. Spared का मतलब villagers अपना वक्त निकालते हैं. They used to take out their time, है ना? Undue hassles, you know, villagers are spared undue hassles and delay. Means they are saying if the justice is delayed, अगर किसी को इंसाफ मिलने में बहुत लेट हो रहा है, इसका मतलब ये क्या है कि उसको इंसाफ नहीं मिल रहा है, इंसाफ नहीं दिया जा रहा है. जस्टिस डिलेड मीन्स व्हाट? जस्टिस को डिले करना, इसका मतलब ये है कि जस्टिस नहीं देना, किसी को इंसाफ नहीं देना. अगर आप इंसाफ नहीं दे सकते हैं तो आप डिले भी मत कीजिए. डोंट डिले द जस्टिस सर. Because if you will spare, if you will waste time, to give justice to the people, then it is not good. Villagers are spared undue hassles and delay. उनको उनके hassles का मतलब बहुत सारे problems होते हैं, है ना? Let me tell you the meaning of different words also over here. Spared, spared का meaning क्या होता है? आपको बता दें कि काम को क्या करना? Delay करना, है ना? That is extra time लेना. And there is no more word, hassle is there. Let me tell you the meaning of the word. Hassle का मतलब क्या होता है? Disorderly fighting, angry disturbance, है ना? यानी कि लोग जो है गुस्सा भी हो जाते हैं अगर उनको जस्टिस नहीं मिलता है, डिले हो जाता है, तो इससे और एक नया चीज खड़ा हो जाता है. Yeah, the न्याय पंचायत comes under the ग्राम पंचायत only, because the ग्राम पंचायत is only the Gram Sabha is only electing the members. So Niyai Panchayat bhi jo hai, wo Gram Panchayat ke andar hi kaam karta hai. Okay, comes under Gram Panchayat, not Jila Parishad. Okay, not Panchayat Samiti. Gram Panchayat uske head hote hai. So justice should not be delayed. That is the thing in Niyai Panchayat. So hope you all understand. If you have any question, then please raise your hand so that we can complete.